Hi, I'm John Bechtold, owner of Spirit of 76 Fireworks. Welcome to our online demo for the 76 Pro line. All of our warehouse and sales operations are up and running, and we are really excited about the 2020 4th of July fireworks season. For tonight's demo, all the items we're going to see tonight are in stock and ready to ship out. We've got a fantastic line of 76 Pro line items, and I'm sure you're gonna enjoy them. So if you're interested in placing an order, reach out to your Spirit of 76 sales rep or go online to 76fireworks.com. Thanks for tuning in and enjoy the 76 Pro line demo.
Hello everyone, and welcome to another Spirit of 76 virtual demo. I'm recording in our office. That's right, folks, we're back at it. It is May, the 4th of July is marching down at us, and we're here ready to take care of business. Of course, we've got some new measures in place just to make sure that our clients as well as our staff remain safe, but we're here and it's business as normal. So let us know what we can do to help you out with your firework needs. Tonight's demo showcases our exclusive brand, the 76 Pro line. For those of you that may be new to the 76 Pro line, this line was developed and is curated with the shooter in mind. The product in the Pro line allows for the ultimate precision and control for your fireworks displays. My name is Ben Muzzy, and I'm the sales manager here at Spirit of 76 Fireworks. Really glad to be recording this in the office. Sorry that I won't have my kids around to pop in, but we're here for fireworks, and that's what we're going to show you. This demo is coming at you in 4K, and I hope your internet connection can handle it. When it comes to showing off the Pro line, we have a hard time not shooting everything. So of course, we've got a lot of product to show you tonight. And all the videos that we're gonna show you are fresh. We just shot all these items you'll see a few days ago. We picked all this product from our warehouse, which means, that's right, these videos are of production run products and they're in stock ready for you to buy. And what would the Pro line demo be without some choreography? So make sure you stick around for the pyro musical at the end. We shot that just for this demo tonight. If you're looking for a printable shoot list, you've got one at magic this website right here, 76fireworks.com/May15th. You can print that there and that will stay with us for the entirety. So don't go rushing off right now. That same link has the form that you can fill out to enter into our giveaway drawings. That's right, folks. You've heard about the swag bags, and they're back. So we will be announcing the winners in the chat section throughout our demo this evening. So make sure you go to 76fireworks.com/May15 and fill out your information there. And we'll have a break about halfway through the demo tonight, give you a chance to get up, move around, and hear a little bit from our KCAP and MoPyro folks. Look forward to hearing from our Missouri Pyro Clubs. Well, with that, folks, let's see some fireworks. Ken Huff, one of our talented pyrotechnicians, is ready to take you through the demo. See you in a little bit.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to Spirit of 76's Spring 2020 Pro Line Demo. Right now, we're standing in front of the retail location here at Midway. We're getting ready to head on over to the arena where we're going to do tonight's display. This is Ken with Spirit of 76 Fireworks. I wear a lot of hats here at 76 Fireworks besides this Pro line hat. I work with the choreography, the pyro, do a little truck driving. We're gonna head over to the antique mall, so come on everybody, let's go. All right, everybody, this is the arena field. If anybody's ever been to a Midway event to see one of our firework demos, Andy is just finishing up landing a few of the Cobra mods for the event. We have 83 items, I believe, tonight that we are going to shoot for you. And we have a surprise at the end of our demo. So when the demo's over, be sure and stay tuned. All right, we got 83 items that we're going to show you tonight. So let's get on with the show. All right, this here is our Pro line 100 shot confetti cake. It's angled, set it on the ground. It's angled to shoot this way. Shoots confetti. It is our only daytime item tonight. GM 587. These cakes come two to a case. All right, next up is item SE418. This is our blue to silver to gold three-layer gerb. They last about approximately 20 seconds, and they go about as high as 15 feet. There's 24 to a case. This is the ProLine Silver Wheel, SC-435. It spins for approximately 40 seconds. These are 8 to a case, 2 to a box, 4 boxes in a case. Take a look at it here. We've got this plastic piece that goes in the middle here, and there's 2 nails that come in the box. And so our nail is not going to go like that. It's going to go like this. And that's going to back up to our post. And you want this nail to go in straight and level. If not, you're going to have problems. Very cool effect. These things look really, really good when they're going. Fuse is right here. We're going to put our E-match in here like so. Now, I like to bring it down where it's got a little tension. So this thing's going to fire. It should burn off right in here. And then our wheel will ignite and it'll start spinning around. Okay, next up is our 12-shot Gold Wave Comet, which is not at this location. All right, number 4 on our shoot list is MS-433. It's our 12-shot Gold Wave Comet. It lasts approximately 30 seconds, and it comes 8 to a case. If you're thinking about investing in gold and silver this year for your fireworks show, that's a good gold cake to invest in. Okay, number 5 tonight, MS-434. This is our 25-shot Falling Leaves Color Assortment case. In this case, you're going to have 2 of each color. There's going to be 2 reds, 2 greens, 2 yellows, 2 blues. Here's our 12-shot red flying fish. That is item number MS-581. Yeah, I'm gonna check real quick. I believe these are 6 to a case. Better deal, 8 to a case.
Hey!
Hey, Hey, guess what? We also have them in silver.
What?
Yeah.
Also 8 to a case?
Let me check, Sam.
I bet they are.
Hey, Sam, guess what? 8 to a case.
Sweet. What's that product ID?
And that product ID is MS580.
It's swag bag time. One viewer has just been selected as our first winner. Are you the lucky viewer to win that swag goodie bag? Check the chat now to see if it's your name. And while you're checking things out, have you checked out the new 76 ProLine website yet? At 76ProLine.com, you can view the entire product line, plus watch displays and behind-the-scenes footage in our display showcase. Check our blog there to see the latest ProLine and fireworks news. And if you're interested in shooting your own display, you can find lots of useful materials in our display resources section, so you can recreate something you've seen in one of our past displays. This site is the spot for all things 76 ProLine. Well, thank you. And now back to the field.
The fireworks you're going to see shot 8, 9, 10, and 11 are part of our 12-shot finale boxes. These come 8 to a case. Each one that we're going to be shooting tonight will be shot, we'll be shooting two at a time. And the first one that we'll be shooting, MS-497, that's our 12-shot finale box color stars. These will launch, like I said, all at the same time. So it's going to fill the sky really fast, really quick with sound and sight. MS-496 is our 12-shot finale box red, white, and blue peonies. MS-498, our 12-shot finale box quick crackle, a favorite one here. A lot of people like to use that at the end of their shows. MS-495, 12-shot finale box, time ring crackle. That's probably second in our in what we sell for our finale boxes. All right, folks, number 12 on the shoot list tonight. GM-524C, 4 to a case. It's our 49-shot Z Colorful World of Ghost Mines. This one goes fast. It lasts about 12 seconds. Very cool effect. On our shoot list tonight, folks, GM-730. This is a new item this year. Comes 2 to a case. 70-shot Z Colorful World of Comets. Has a nice rainbow of colors, folks. This cake lasts approximately 17 seconds. It's quick, but very beautiful effect. All right, folks, number 14 tonight on our shoot list, GM-645. These come 4 to a case. There are 25 shot Z Brocade Skymine. Number 15 on our shoot list tonight, folks, GM585A. This is our 30-shot Z gold mine to gold brocade crown. Lasts approximately 20-25 seconds. Comes 4 to a case. All right, number 16 on our shoot list tonight is GM437. It's our 36-shot multicolor peony. Lasts approximately 25 seconds. Comes 4 cakes to a case. Once again, that's our 36-shot multicolor peony. All right, next up on our shoot list, item number 17, another favorite one. People just seem to love this effect. It is our 10-shot Super Silver Flash. I think at one time we called it the Super Silver Strobe. Does that sound right?
I think so.
I think so too, Sam. That one comes 4 to a case. You're going to love it, folks. All right, folks, number 18 on your shoot list is GM524A. These come 4 to a case. It's the 49-shot Z Crackling Mine. It's another cake that throws up a lot of fire, a lot of pyro in the air. It lasts approximately 12 seconds.
We have another giveaway. Check the comment section to see if you've won a 76 swag bag. Our website will show you real-time inventory. Don't believe me? Go ahead and check it out. You'll see a green dot by all the products we are shooting tonight, which means those are in stock in our warehouse right now. The other stock status colors you'll see are yellow, which means that the item is en route to our warehouse and the estimated arrival date shows under the product name, and red, which means that product has not left our manufacturers yet. Once it is moving our direction, that red will turn yellow, and we'll have that estimated arrival date for you. Thank you. Now let's get back to fireworks. Take it away, Ken.
All right, folks. Here we have item GM524B as in boy. It is a 49-shot Z Gold strobe mine. Lasts approximately 12 seconds. This is our 32nd gold strobe cake, GM432. 4 to a case.
we have our 20-shot Pixie Dust Waterfall. It's 25 seconds. That's GM 426. They come four to a case. Very nice effect. You know, it's used in a lot of different pirate musicals. Quiet, but it's got a waterfall effect that, yeah, makes for some good intense soft spots in music. All right, item number 24 tonight on our shoot list. This is probably one of those effects that a lot of companies try to copy this, just can't get it like we've got it. We're the original in this pro consumer with the Nishiki Camaro. It's GM 691, folks, or it comes four to a case. This is a 9-shot Nishiki Camaro. Lasts approximately 40 to 45 seconds. This is, like I said, this is probably one of the best effects that was taken from the 1-3 world, 1-1 world, and brought into the 1-4 world on our pro consumer. Like I said, this is often copied, but they can't do what ProLine has done.
It's a rugged looking box, yep, but it will shoot beautifully.
And we have our 49-shot red, white, and blue Go-Getters, GM 491, 4-2 a case. Go-Getters, I haven't found anybody that doesn't like the Go-Getters.
I love the Go-Getters.
One of those things, you never know where they're going to go. Number 27 tonight on our demo list is GM 693D, and these come four to a case. It's our 30-shot red, white, and blue bouquet, approximately 25 seconds. And we are going to be shooting two pieces simultaneously tonight. All right, number 28 on our list tonight, GM 438. This comes four to a case. It's our 36-shot red, white, and blue peony. Lasts approximately 25 seconds. Number 29 on our shoot list tonight, folks, GM 433 is a color assortment case. These come four cakes to a case. We have a red, white, blue, and a crackle cake, all four individual cakes. Tonight, we're going to shoot the red cake, the white cake, and the blue cake. These will be shot at the same time. right, folks, number 30 tonight on our shoot list, GM 643. It's our 12-shot red, white, and blue dahlia assortment. Tonight, we are going to be shooting simultaneously a red dahlia cake, a white dahlia cake, and a blue dahlia cake. These come three to a case.
It's swag bag time. Check the comments section to see if you get the goods. We're about to go on a brief intermission, but before you make that beverage or bathroom run, hit the subscribe button. We post fireworks related content on our YouTube channel all throughout the season. You don't want to miss out, so go ahead, hit that subscribe button. And during this break, I'm going to hand it off to Dan the Man Haynes. You may know him as the Spirit of 76 resident pyro expert or the 76 Pro Line product manager. However you know him, he has a message for you about our annual Missouri Fireworks Club Showdown.
Hey guys, Dan Haynes here with Spirit of 76. As many of you know, each year, Spirit of 76 hosts the Missouri Fireworks Club Showdown in partnership with Finale Fireworks and Cobra Firing Systems. Unfortunately, we're not able to do that this year, but good news, we've got it rescheduled on the books for our spring demo next year. We're going to have MoPyro and KCAP, two of the best fireworks clubs in the Missouri area, out, and they're going to be putting on some amazing shows for us again next year. This year would have been the fifth year of the competition, pitting KCAP against MoPyro, which also would have been a tiebreaker year. In past years, both clubs have put on some really amazing shows. We've had two victories from KCAP and two victories from MoPyro. But we're looking forward to having both the clubs back next year to determine who's going to be the Missouri Fireworks Club Showdown champion. We did want to include the clubs in the demo in some way, so Sam sat down with a couple of the members to have a chat. Let's take a look.
So we're talking with Jim Preby from the Kansas City Area Pyrotechnics Club. Tell me a little bit about KCAP.
It started with a group of about a dozen members back in 2011. And has since just grown now about 70 members. And what started as a very local club for the Kansas City area, hence the name, the Kansas City Area Pyrotechnicians, has now grown into a regional group. We've got members from Missouri, Kansas, Arkansas, Oklahoma, and Nebraska.
When did you start being involved?
Oh, it's been about 7 years ago.
How many shows do you guys usually shoot in a year?
For club events, we usually have about 5 formal club events. This year, it's been a little bit shortened because of COVID. We're still going to try to make them up, I guess. We're usually involved in pyromania in some way and just other local shoots.
What are your kind of favorite memories of being in KCAP?
Really, one of the other things that's really nice about this club, and a lot of people that talk about it, but we're a very social club. We usually have like a monthly meeting at some restaurant somewhere, and we just kind of get together, you know, whoever can come that time. So not only do we get together for pyro stuff, but we get together just for socially as well.
What was your kind of reaction when you heard that we had to cancel our demo and the showdown?
Well, it's kind of been disappointing just all across the board, and you know, I haven't really heard of any live demos going on this year and doing the streaming ones, which actually was really kind of a nice touch. And again, it's not quite the same. You can't smell the smoke and you can't hear or feel the thumps as you might over your little computer speakers. But this too shall pass and things will hopefully get back to normal.
Well, let's talk about last year's competition. You guys, yep. KCAP won last year. And of course, both shows were amazing, but you guys really, really knocked it out of the park. So this year would have been a tiebreaker year for the competition. And now you guys have to wait a whole extra year for that chance to claim the championship. What is that like? Obviously, it's a bummer, but...
Well, we, we know the script is already there. And so it's just a matter of resurrecting it next year.
Well, that's good that you guys are already prepared, and hopefully this extra time will give you enough time to tweak it and just basically bring your all in 2021. As far as KCAP in the area, are you guys accepting new members at this time?
We are always accepting new members.
Wonderful.
And if people are interested in learning a little bit more about the club and looking at cost, we also have a family membership. We actually have quite a few couples. We have quite a few female pyros.
Yeah.
And in fact, every once in a while, we actually even field a female pyro team. And we have quite a few families, actually. And that's kind of growing. So if you want to find out about us, they can go to www.kcap.us. And we can also find us on Facebook. Just type in Kansas City Area Pyrotechnicians.
Thank you. Thank you for chatting with me for our demo. I'm really excited to see the shows that you and the other club bring in 2021. Is there anything else you'd like to say on the recording for about KCAP or about the competition?
Just a general invite to folks that might have a little bit more interest in pyrotechnics. You have an absolute wealth of skill and knowledge to tap into when you join our club.
This is Steve Hall from the Missouri Pyrotechnics Association, aka MoPyro. Welcome, Steve.
Welcome.
Could you please tell us a little bit about how long MoPyro has existed and kind of what that timeline looked like?
Okay, I actually founded MoPyro back in the early 90s, about 92. And I put an ad in American Fireworks News asking if anyone wanted to start up a club in the St. Louis area. And I originally got two replies. Both those guys are still in the club to this day. That was in probably 93. And decided there wasn't enough interest for a club. And I met those two guys and we got together and did fireworks for a year or two and started talking it up with other people. And a group down in St. Louis got involved, and somebody volunteered to be president, and I volunteered to be safety director, and we took off in the mid-90s.
You guys are based out in the St. Louis area, correct?
Right.
How many shows or events do you guys usually have in a typical year?
Yeah, a normal year, we have five events. Four MoPyro shoots, we call them, and then the Power Mania event.
For people wanting to know more about the event and the event that you guys put on, you guys have a website dedicated to it, correct?
That's right, Pyromania Facebook page.
What are some of your favorite memories of being in the club, of, you know, what favorite shoot sites, favorite years or events that you've had?
Yeah, the number one shoot site is in Bowling Green, Missouri. It's a good friend of mine that owns a farm up there. That's where I'm based out of. I have a magazine there. And that's where we got started, in his backyard, shooting homemade 3-inch shells through the trees in his backyard in the mid-90s. So we still do two shows a year there. And we bring in as many 400 or 500 people now. And I look back every time I see the crowds and think about where we started with two or three guys shooting homemade shells out of their backyard.
So as you know, we had to cancel this year's showdown. KCAP won last year's competition, and so now you guys, MoPyro, has to wait a whole extra year just for the chance to redeem yourselves. What's that like? Is that kind of like a blessing and a curse?
Yeah, I think I have no doubt that we have some fantastic choreographers in the club, so I have no doubt we'll be competitive any year, anytime.
From all our previous competitions, you guys, we can see your guys' shows on our YouTube channel and on our 76 ProLine website. And we also have a lot of your show resources in our display resources section. So that's really cool if anyone wanted to go in and see how you guys made that. And are you guys always accepting new members?
Yes, of course. We've gotten quite a few members over the last few years because of the popularity of Pyromania. if people find out there about MoPyro and what we do. We also have our own website, mopyro.org, and you can go on there. People Google us, just a lot of, by word of mouth. There's a lot of different ways.
Well, is there anything else you'd like people to know about MoPyro?
Just that we're still up and running, and we plan to have a major Pyromania event, and we still, we've got a our first shoot scheduled for the Bowling Green site the first Saturday in June.
All right. Well, Steve, thank you so much for talking with me today, and very excited to see your show both this year and the competition that you guys bring in 2020.
Okay. I hope to be there.
Hey, thanks to all you Pyro Club members who just shared your experiences. It's unfortunate that we can't have a display competition this spring, but have no fear. It will be back next year, and the clubs will be bringing their all in 2021. Well, we've got the second half of the shoot list, so let's pick up where we left off with more fireworks. Ken, if you'd be so kind.
All right, next on our shoot list, number 31, GM364A. They come forward to a case. This is our 36-shot finale box. This is Humming Snakes. You know, a lot of people use them at the end. I use them throughout the song, depending on the song, and if I want some screams, because these things, like, go screeching, they go very fast. All right, folks, next up we're gonna have our tracer comets. These are our smaller comets. We have red, which is SC461. We have green, which is SC462, and we have them in yellow, SC463. Each color comes 24 to a case. These next comets, we'll start off here with CM209A. This is our silver cascade comet, 40 millimeter, 24 to a case, probably one of our popular comets here at 76. Next item up, CM210A. Gold Wave Comet, 40 millimeter, also 24 to a case. And our next comet in this line that we're shooting tonight is CM223A. It is our White Star Comet, 24 to a case, also 40 millimeter tube. These next set of comets are our no debris comets. They're all 30 millimeter tubes. They're designed to go off and not have anything come back down on the ground. These are can be used for close procs, outside use, where you don't have to worry about if there's a wind, any debris falling on the crowd. You see these right here on the pyrolamas? This is actually built in to the comet. We have this E-match here, and I don't wanna mess up anything before the display.
No, we can see it, yeah.
But these come built on, so if you're using a pyrolama system or you order our 76 sliders, same kind of design that you can screw down onto 2x4s, plywood. Pretty much use your imagination, come up with all kinds of different angles and effects. But these comets here, along with our no debris mines, all have the built-in slider. So we have CM301, and all of these come 24 to a case. CM301, which is our Silver Cascade no debris slider comet. CM302, which is our Gold Wave comet, 30 millimeter, 24 to a case. Silver Cascade Comet with red and blue mines, 30 millimeter, 24 to a case. Then we're going to have CM321. This is our blue to red star comet with white strobe mine, 24 to a case. CM322, cracking comet with crackling mine, 24 to a case. CM323 is our orange star comet with crackling mine, also 24 to a case. And that covers our notable comets that we'll be shooting this evening.
Tell us about those tourbillon with go-getters.
Okay, the MN228A, 24 to a case. That's our tourbillon with purple go-getter mine. We also have MN221A, which is our tourbillon with red go-getter mine, also 24 to a case. All right, folks, next on our shoot list is 50 millimeter mines. One thing that folks are going to know right away that have bought ProLine, that have bought our ProLine mines before, these are almost twice as tall
as regular, our
this
other
is
mines.
Our older style, or an older style that we've used for a while. These have a taller tube.
I see.
It's been said that the taller the tube, the higher the product goes. We're going to find out this year if that's the case or not. That's MN238A Pixie Dust Mine, our MN239A Blue Mine with Pixie Dust, and MN240A Red Mine with Pixie Dust. All of these mines are 24 to a case. Here we've got a variety of different mines. These ones here in the black tubes are our no debris mines. Very good for close prox type shows that you're shooting outdoors and you don't want any debris falling on the crowd. These run MN300 for a variety pack, which has MN301, MN302, MN303, 304, 305, and 306. They come in a variety of colors. MN301 is a red dahlia mine, no debris. MN302 is a blue dahlia mine, no debris. MN303, no debris, it's a green dahlia mine. MN304 is a yellow dahlia mine. MN305 is a purple dahlia mine. And MN306 is our orange dahlia mine.
So, Ken, what is the difference between a fan slice and a fan sweep and a super slice and a super sweep?
Okay, well, we have 7-shot, 13-shot, and 15-shot. Our slice is going to shoot them all off at the same time. Dan Haynes tries to get creative.
Yeah, we don't like creativity.
Okay, our 15 shot are the super slices.
It's time. Check the comment section now to see if you get one of our swag bags delivered by drone. Just kidding. We'll mail it to you. But do check now to see if you're the winner. What's that? Breaking news! Spirit of 76 is rolling out more webinars. Check them out at 76fireworks.com/webinars. There you can see the full listing of all of our free upcoming webinars and watch recordings gone by. I'll let Dan tell you about our next webinar, and then we have more items and one more giveaway. So don't go anywhere, folks. We'll be back in a moment.
Hey guys, our next webinar is going to be on pyromusical design in Finale 3D. The two-hour webinar is being taught by myself and Peter Rogos. We're going to take you through the design of a basic display using Finale 3D. We'll create the whole show from beginning to end, cover everything from music selection, editing, site layout, product selection, and addressing your show. If you're interested, this is going to take place Friday, May 22nd at 2 p.m. And you can go to 76fireworks.com/webinars to register. Should be a lot of fun, and I hope to see you there.
Thank you. Now let's get back to fireworks. Take it away, Ken.
Okay. A sweep will sweep left to right, right to left, center out, center. You can start in the center and go outwards, or you can start out and go in. That's going to be the sweep. Our 13 shot, we just call those fan sweeps. And then if it's a 15 shot, it's a super sweep. You know, one of our favorite sweeps is our ghost sweep, where it changes to three different colors.
Mm-hmm.
Once it's fired off.
We have one of those on the shoot list, right?
We do. And that one is item number... Oh, Sam, you sprung one on me here. That is item number 75 tonight on our shoot list, SE-170. This is our 15-shot ghost sweep, green to blue to red.
It's
So we are at the end of our shoot list, aren't we?
We are. These are 60 millimeter single shot tubes. A lot of our effects that we have in our cakes and comets or mines, some of those special effects, we've built into a much bigger effect, the 60 millimeter effect. Any of these items, 76 through 83, we're gonna be shooting two simultaneously, 15 degree angle. Or item number 76 on your shoot list, TB410. This is our red, white, and blue strobing peony. These come 18 to a case. So it's bigger than the 2-inch tube that you're getting in like a 9-shot or 12-shot cake. These are going to go up a little bit higher, go off a little bit louder, and the breaks will be a little bit bigger. Next up is item 77, TB411, 18 to a case. This is our multicolor dahlia, 60 millimeter single shot. Then we have item number 78. This is on our shoot list. This is product number TB412, 18 shots per case. Brocade crown, 60 millimeter single shot. All right, item number 79 on our shoot list. This is product number TB413. These come 18 to a case, and this is our time ring crackle, single shot. Number 80 on our shoot list is TB425, 18 to a case. It's red sun ring, very nice effect. We came out with this effect last year. It's, I think right, it might've came in just before the 4th, maybe a little after the 4th. Very cool effect. You see this in a lot of the bigger 1-3 shells. Number 81 on our shoot list. This is another one that we sell out of a lot. TB420, 18 tubes to a case. This is our single 60 millimeter Nishiki Kimura. If you think that the 9-shot Nishiki cake has a cool Nishiki effect, wait till you try out the 60 millimeter. Goes up higher, breaks a little bigger, and last a little longer coming down. Number 82 on our shoot list is TB422, 18 to a case. This is our crackling palm with crackling tail. And number 83.
Our very last one.
This is our last one before our special surprise at the end of the demo tonight, folks.
Oh, yeah.
So stay tuned. All right. Item number 83, TB423. Very cool effect. You know, I like this effect. I've seen it in the 1-3. We now have it in our pro consumer line. This is another one that we got in last year, kind of towards the end. I don't know if it quite made it out before the 4th, but it is our red, white, and blue jellyfish, 60 millimeter single shot. And Sam, if you can go back and edit this, okay?
Nope.
All right, folks, this is Ken back here with you. We're at the end of our demo. I just want to say thank you for watching our demo. You know, these videos are fun to put out, but I sure miss the crowd, and I sure miss the interaction of you, our clients and customers, coming out here, and I hope things get back to normal real soon. And miss you guys, Everybody stay safe this next couple of months and stay healthy. Every once in a while, I've mentioned that we have a surprise tonight after the show. Well, I'm going to give you a little bit more information. Sam, our person in marketing that comes up with all these great videos. In fact, she's standing on the other side of the camera right now. That's Sam waving at you. Has designed her first pyro musical tonight, folks. Yay. This is her design. This is her music that she put together. She scripted the show. And so everybody here at 76 is excited to see what Sam can do out there on the field.
But if it's awful, it wasn't mine.
It's going to be great, Sam. Once again, from everybody here at the Spirit of 76, thank you.
Ken Hoff, thank you for taking us through tonight's demo. And Dawn, thank you for letting Ken hang out with us so much. Ken, time for Tito's and water, buddy. Now, you're all winners in my book, but when it comes to the book of swag bags, there's only one more winner. Check the comments section now. I really hope that you win. And that wraps up our virtual product demonstration dedicated to the 76 Pro line. Thank you so much for tuning in. A few quick reminders before we get to the finale show. All the items you saw this evening are in stock at our warehouse, and all the videos you saw this evening are of stock production. That's right, folks. What you see is what you get. Don't let someone else get the pyro that you want. Get your order in now. And you can see our full product line, performance videos, build your order, see the shipping cost, and place your order at 76fireworks.com. Remember, when you place your order, the product is reserved for you. The wonderful 76 sales team is going to be in the office and ready to assist tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. Central. So give your salesperson a call on their dedicated number or dial our main line, 573-447-1776. That website I just mentioned, 76fireworks.com, that bad boy is open 24/7 and is ready to accept your order now. To register for our upcoming webinars and view our full webinar library, go to 76fireworks.com/webinars. And be sure to check that site regularly because we love adding to that list. For updates and more content on all things fireworks, follow us on social media at 76fireworks on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. If you didn't do it at intermission, Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. On behalf of everyone here at 76 Fireworks, I want to say thank you for letting us bring the 76 Pro line into your home this evening. We had a blast and hope you did too. Continue to take care of yourselves and your family. Let us know how we can help out with your fireworks needs. Okay, folks, I'm going to go get a drink and some shut-eye. I got a big day of fireworking tomorrow. Have a great night. I'll give it over to Sam to introduce the finale. Bye, everybody.
Hey guys, welcome to the end of the demo. As Ken mentioned earlier, we are shooting a pyro musical. It's a short little show that I designed and it is my very first time scripting a show ever. Does it turn out to be exactly the way I imagined it in my head? Of course not. Did we have to do some last minute swaps and item reorganization? Of course, that always happens in pyro. But in the end, I'm really, really happy I got the opportunity to shoot a show. I gained a lot of experience. I learned a whole lot. And I wanna thank the pyro crew, Dan, Ken, Andy, and our friend Curtis for helping out set it all up. And I also wanna thank Dan Haynes for helping me script it. So here it is. I hope you guys enjoy. It is a pandemic-themed pyro musical.
This is a test. This station is conducting a test of the emergency broadcasting system. This is only a test.
That's great. It starts with an earthquake. Birds and snakes and aeroplane. Lenny Bruce is not a
of the world as we know it. It's the alert system capabilities.
Thank you.